But on a more somber note, unfortunately, things turned ugly at the Capitol with violence. There's absolutely nothing funny about that. Before those unfortunate events, protesters stormed the Capitol, as you can see here, when barricades were opened for them by police. Conspiracy theorists suggest the most unruly protesters were Antifa in disguise, just trying to wreak havoc to make Trump and all his supporters look like they're dangerous and trying to overthrow democracy. Well, luckily, our fact checkers have debunked this claim as false, citing the latest science that shows Antifa wouldn't dress like this. The fact checkers also deny that it's even possible the same alleged Antifa member was at a BLM rally in Arizona in June. And here he is pictured at that rally, so you can be certain of what didn't happen, according to our fact checkers. And as you can see, socialist media giant Twitter now lets you know through a manipulated media thought control warning that no Antifa activists stormed the Capitol, according to multiple fact checkers. And the fact that Twitter does this doesn't make it any more suspicious. The fact checkers will also let you know that this Trump supporter is definitely not Antifa. That's why he has the communist hammer and sickle tattooed on his hand, like most Trump supporters do. And the most disturbing part of this story that we command you to believe is that President Trump was personally inciting these protesters to violence. So much so that Twitter removed a video Trump posted where he said to his supporters at the Capitol, "You have to go home now. We have to have peace. We have to have law and order." We have the video of Trump's words destroying our narrative about him. Oh yeah, so we're not playing the video, right? Duh, of course not. You ready? That was followed by both Facebook and Twitter locking Trump out of his accounts. Big tech, the new government that governs our government, heroically stepped in and prevented people from hearing Trump say, "You have to go home, we have to have peace." One can only imagine the further violence and carnage that would have happened if Twitter and Facebook let people see that video. Once again, big tech steps in and has done something for us, for our protection. Thank God for big tech. A woman. Late in the night, the Senate voted to reject the objection to Electoral College votes from Pennsylvania. Shocker. And then the House voted to certify the election results. Joe Biden is now the president-elect. He will be your next president. After the vote, President Trump issued a statement, not on Twitter for some reason, vowing a peaceful transition of power. To all of us here at the media, that sounds like he's inciting violence and refusing to leave office. This just in! The few can only control the many if you are in a state of fear. Bravery and saying no to surrendering your rights is what will keep you free. The hell is this? We didn't discuss this at Event 201. Come on, who the hell is doing this? That's it for today's news. Tune in tomorrow as we'll be reporting on the latest science that shows doing your own thinking causes cancer, but letting the media do your thinking for you is healthy. No need to go back to sleep because you already are. Sweet dreams.